Hi, this video is called Area of the Shaded Region 1. You are going to see a lot of problems like this from here until the end of geometry class, so get used to the idea of finding areas of shaded regions. The most important thing you can do is to make sense of the picture. I look at this picture and I see a giant rectangle and then I see two smaller squares. Now let me just imagine for a second that this big rectangle is a dark piece of construction paper, like green or brown or purple or something like that. And then you took a scissors and you cut out the two squares. So now you can see through the paper there. It's almost like it's a mask where the two squares are the part where your eyes could see through. That's how I like to imagine it. Okay? So to find the area of the shaded region, well, I think I'm going to start by finding the area of the whole thing. So in this particular problem, the whole thing is the big rectangle. And then I'm going to subtract out the two squares I cut out, the parts I can see through now. So I'm going to do the area of the whole thing minus the area of the white. So in this problem, we have two parts to it. We need to find the area of the whole thing. We need to find the area of the white cutouts. And then we'll see if we can combine like terms at the end. All right? Well, the area of the white square should be easy because you can see. You're just going to do side length times side length or base times height. 3 times 3 gives you 9. Sorry about that. And then the other square is also a 3 by 3. 3 times 3 is 9. Sorry, they like the overhead today. Anyway, so the area of the white parts, we've got 9 plus 9, which is going to be 18. So the area of the white part is 18 units squared. I'm not going to worry about putting the label on until I'm totally done. So I'm just going to write 18 for the white part. Now, onto the area of the whole thing. This isn't too much worse because you look at the area of the whole thing. Well, we have a big rectangle. An area of a rectangle is base times height. So it looks like we're simply going to have to do 2 root 5 times 6 root 5. So remember, the 2 and the 6 can multiply to become 12 because they're both outside the square root. The 5 and the 5 is the square root of 25. Well, the square root of 25 is 5. 12 times 5 is 60. So the area of the whole thing is 60. So now all we have left to do is combine our answers. 60 minus 18. Well, 60 and 18 are both constants, so they are like terms. So we can do the subtraction and we get 42. And here is where we'll put our label on. Since it's area, it will be units squared. Like I said, it's just important to make sense of the picture. Probably the most important part of this problem is figuring out the setup. It was the area of the whole minus the area of the white, because then you just do it individually, piece by piece, and at the end, try to put it all together. You have one more video for tonight, and it's going to be another problem similar to this.